This video is brought to you by CatBeast.com. Design your own custom snapbacks and hats.
¿Qué pasa to the pack? It is Pack here,
aka your mama's best friend.
And the Phoenix Suns have made a trade that has maybe changed Devin Booker's career forever and maybe even made the Suns playoff contenders. I'll cover that in a second, but before this video starts though, be an OG, join the pack and subscribe, and also leave a like on the video. You'd be surprised how much it helps the channel out. So, the Phoenix Suns have traded multiple players, but I'll start off with Kelly Oubre. They've traded Ricky Rubio, Ty Jerome, and also Jalen Lecque for straight up Chris Paul and also Abdel Nader. So they have made some big trades. I'll push that right now. So now the Phoenix Suns have Devin Booker and Chris Paul tied as the best player on the team. Now, if I'm going to make a wild guess, I'm going to assume throughout the season that Devin Booker is going to be considered the best player on the team, but Chris Paul is a major upgrade. Now, you do lose Kelly Oubre, who was very good for the team. A crazy slasher that was getting crazy posters and still shooting at a high level, so he was a great player for the Phoenix Suns, and I do think that he helped them succeed the way that he played. But adding Chris Paul, who is one of the best pure point guards in the league and a pure winner, he just wins. Adding him to this team is important because you're building a winning culture for the Phoenix Suns, which is absolutely mandatory for this team. They need somebody that is going to put them in the right path and teach them how to win. Plus, you had DeAndre Ayton, who was improving considering the last year, on 18 points per game, on 1.5 blocks, great efficiency, and 11, almost 12 rebounds a game, and only playing 38 games last year for multiple reasons. So next year, you can expect them to increase even more. And it's going to be exciting when you have Devin Booker, DeAndre Ayton rising to star level. And then you have Chris Paul, who's going to help them make sure they win. And you still have Aaron Baines, who had a great season last year. You have Mikal Bridges, who is young and is getting better. Cameron Johnson. Like, you have players on this team. Dario Saric, who can play good when needed. Javon Carter, who played well last season. So you do have players on this team that can win. And then on top of it all, they also get Abdel Nader, who was on the Thunder, 26 years old, 71 overall with 6 points per game. I'm sure he'll find a role on this team because the rest of the team is pretty lacking for the most part. I mean, it really is just like a big three for them. But I think in the West, if it's done right, and they maybe they even get someone in free agency, they can do something special here, but we shall see how the season turns out. But I think this is very important for Devin Booker because he needed, I think, somebody to really help him win. And I think that's going to happen. Even if Chris Paul is 35 years old, going on to 36, it's not going to matter because of how good of a player he is, technically sound, right? And then now we have the Oklahoma City Thunder. You have Gilgeous Alexander, who is an 84 overall, now is going to be clearly the best player on the team. You have Danilo Gallinari, 83 overall, who might be leaving. It's a big question mark so far, but he could be leaving. Steven Adams, who has always been good for the team. Now you add Kelly Oubre, who is younger and getting better every single year. Again, last year he averaged 19 a game on 6 rebounds and also had good efficiency and okay 3-point field goal percentage, but still, he's getting better and he's still only 24. And then you have Ricky Rubio adding, who is a pure point guard that's very good. You have added players that's going to help you succeed in time. I think it's a smart move. You also add Ty Jerome, who's not terrible at all, and you also add Jalen Lecque, who's young. So, and then you have so many draft picks. That's what the Thunder really did. They just wanted all these draft picks, and it's a smart decision by them. They want to win. It's a smart decision by them. They're thinking about the future while not really letting go of success now, which I think is a good job. I think that they do get worse and that they might not make the playoffs this year because of this, but I could be wrong. Who knows? Maybe Gilgeous Alexander really is that guy. I mean, he is young and he is the future for this team. I think they also have a new coach, so there's definitely things here pointing at success, but maybe not next season. But we shall see what really happens with this team. Their starting lineup is now Ricky Rubio, Gilgeous Alexander, Kelly Oubre, Danilo Gallinari if he stays, and Steven Adams. So I do think they still have a pretty solid starting lineup, but we shall see how it turns out during the season. It is looking so exciting. I cannot wait, guys. What do you guys think about this trade? Is it cash or trash? Leave it in the comments below. And if you like this channel, give it a sub. And I'll see you guys next time.